shaitan, he even knows that even the minor sins, he can't get the people to do them all the time. So he even has a plan after the minor sins. And that is to get people to busy themselves with things that have no reward. Go shopping, go play computer games, go and talk to your friends, go out, go play pool, go play football, do anything, but don't do something you're going to get rewarded from in the sight of Allah. Look at how much evil, look at how corrupt this heart is. The heart of this Iblis and the heart of these shayateen. That even if they know you're going to go to Jannah, they still want you to get the lowest place in Jannah possible. Even when he knows you're going to Jannah, he says no major sins, no, he's got no minor sins, he's constantly asking forgiveness from Allah, but still I would rather he didn't get a high place in Jannah. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to get him to busy himself all the time with things that have no reward in the sight of Allah. Work, you need the money. Without the money, you won't be able to do anything. Don't study, you don't have time. Don't learn Islam. Don't go to the masjid, you don't have time. You need to work, you need to do this, you need to do that. Oh, don't read the book today. Don't read the Quran today. Let's go out, let's play. Anything to get you to do the things which are of no reward instead of the things which are of reward. But even then, the shaitan knows that there is a group of the people, and there are some of us from time to time in our lives where even this doesn't work. And the shaitan still has a plan for them. He still doesn't give up. He still has a plan for them. And his plan for them is to get them to do those things that have less reward instead of those things which have more reward. So they have an opportunity to do something that has a lot of reward. Let's say the night prayer, Qiyam al-Layl. And so the shaitan will encourage them to sleep in for Qiyam al-Layl in order for them to do a deed which has less reward. So the shaitan, for example, will encourage them to, I don't know, to do something small which takes up their time, something which has less reward, which takes up their time late at night, so that they don't pray Qiyam al-Layl. So he tries to get you some to do something that has less reward instead of something that has more reward. And the key thing about these general aims of the shaitan is we should not understand that each of these has unique groups of people. No, each of these can apply to all of us in our lives. Our iman goes up and down. There are times in our day, in our lives, where we want to do a good deed. At that time we want to do a good deed, the shaitan is going to try to get you to do the least good deed possible. There are times when you want to do major sins, so the shaitan is going to try to encourage you to do those. And he's going to try to get you always to move up a level. So if he's got you doing minor sins, he's going to try to make the major sins, let's get him a step up, major sins. Okay, major sins, let's try and get him maybe to enter into, you know, some kind of bid'ah or something that might lead him to disbelief. And he's going to constantly work to push you up. The shaitan is tireless in this aim because he knows where he is going. He knows about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he knows his final destination is the hellfire. And so he values his time on this earth. Perhaps we don't value our time on this earth, but the shaitan, he values his time on this earth. So he wants to make the maximum use of this time to misguide as many people as possible.